this week's episode of Tea Time. I'm Chaiti Narula, here from the Delhi Golf Club. Of course, New Delhi has a rather historical charm attached to this golf course. It's got a rather quaint, old-school charm right here in the middle of the city of New Delhi. And today, of course, we're here at the Hero Cycles Golf Cup, hosted by the European legend Colin Montgomery. And at this tournament, you will see an array of golfers participating who are basically and primarily kids who are playing this tournament, and who knows, a future champion may emerge from one of these.
A junior golf initiative. So we've got an inter-school tournament going on with school teams from all over the country. Plus, we're doing a fabulous thing for charity fundraising. And with the attraction of Colin Montgomery, we've got people to pitch in with really generous donations.
Not bad. I wouldn't say too good, but I could have paid much better.
This tournament should happen every 6 months. Even if Colin comes here every 6 months, it will be a pleasure.
Great to be here. Great to see the kids play this morning, the children. Fantastic standard of golf.
The Delhi Golf Club at the Hero Cycles Golf Cup 2014 with me is one of the foremost authorities of golf in the country, Rishi Narayan. Rishi, always a pleasure to be talking to you on the show.
Thank you.
Let's talk about bringing Colin Montgomery down to India really for this tournament. What was the whole idea?
Well, you know, the idea was to try and do something that was meaningful, and we've combined two fabulous things. One is a junior golf initiative. So we've got an inter-school tournament going on with school teams from all over the country. Plus, we're doing a fabulous thing for charity fundraising. And with the attraction of Colin Montgomery, we've got people to pitch in with really generous donations. And, you know, overall, it's been a fabulous event in the end.
You know, you use golf quite a lot as a great communication platform through all the marketing spends that we see across all your tournaments as well. Now, Heroes initiative with this particular tournament, take us through that, and how does it benefit Hero?
Well, Hero Cycles obviously is a brand that targets a lot of children.
Right.
So the first thought was that you should do something to connect the brand to children. So we said it's an inter-school golf tournament.
And let's talk about the symbiotic relationship between the Duke of Edinburgh Cup and, of course, the Hero Golf Tournament today that we're talking about. I mean, what is really the association?
Well, the Duke of Edinburgh Cup is a global charity golf tournament,
right,
which consists of a series of charity golf events that happen in various countries around the world.
Right.
So basically, the Duke of Edinburgh Cup selects particular charity golf tournaments in, say, 18 different countries.
Right.
And then the winners of those charity tournaments all meet in a world final, which happens in London in October.
Right.
So, you know, this tournament has been nominated now for the next 3 years to be the official charity event for the Duke of Edinburgh Cup. And therefore, our winners get to go to the world final, which includes an incredible experience, which is, you know, you play at the private course of the royal family inside the grounds of Windsor Castle.
Beautiful.
It's just stunning, and it's a money can't buy, because you just cannot play that golf course.
Absolutely.
It's only open to the people who in the castle, you know, as permanent staff,
right,
or for this event. And also you can you attend a dinner with the prince inside Windsor Castle in the state ballroom, black tie dinner with tuxedos and champagne, and it's just such a great experience.
Sure.
But for all these people who have contributed to the charity,
right,
it's a prize which you know, hopefully they'll find sort of meaningful.
Yeah, all the best for that, and thank you so much for joining me on TV.
Thanks very much, Eddie. Thank you.
Colin and Pankaj to please go ahead and cut the ribbon to inaugurate the tournament.
Well done. Well done.
One of the most phenomenal parts of being at a golf tournament is the vibe that you get over here. 48 kids waiting to tee off from the first hole. Their breakfast is over. And of course, we have 48 independent entries as well who are playing for charity as well here at the Delhi Golf Club. Let's take a look at all that action. Take a break. We'll see you on the other side. From the first tee off all the way to the 18 holes, we bring you all the action on the other side. Take a break.
Great to be here. Great to see the kids play this morning, the children. Fantastic standard of golf. And we have to thank Hero. You know, we have to thank Hero Cycles for bringing this all together.
Thank you for staying with us on Tea Time and welcome back. And as I mentioned earlier, the tournament is just about to begin. The kids and of course the 48 golfers who are playing for charity as well are just about to come here to the first hole to tee off and play their 18 holes today. Of course, a splendid show put up by Rishi Narayan Golf Management as always, and Hero Cycles adding their bit to it as well. Let's take a look at how the entire day pans out for these golfers.
It was pretty much challenging. About noon it became very dry and hot, so the conditions were different from one in the morning.
DGC is always challenging because of the narrow fairways.
It's quite challenging because the fairways are pretty narrow and there are many bushes, so I think it's a challenging course.
The course is in a very pretty condition, so yeah, it was nice. It was nice playing the course.
Oh, this is a very challenging course. Narrow fairways, small greens, but yeah, if you hit it straight and make chip putts, then you will play very well.
It's really challenging. It's really narrow and I guess it's one of the best courses in India and it's really challenging.
Lot of up and downs, but still I managed to do well, and in the end I shot a good score.
Not bad, I wouldn't say too good, but it was not bad. Like I could have played much better.
I missed a lot of short putts, so I ended up shooting like a kind of a high score, but yeah, I mean it's just because of the course itself, it like overwhelms you.
I didn't play that well, but yeah, it was good. It was fun playing with Seher and Gaurika.
It's good. The morning temperatures and the noon temperatures varied a lot because so then the game also affects, like we have to change our strategy around the holes, so that changes. And but it was good, like I managed the score. And my game was also pretty good throughout the round.
It was good. It was very good, I'd say. Not my best, but it was really good. The course was playing tough, so I'm really happy with my game.
This tournament has been conducted really well. So yeah, it is very encouraging for us and for everybody over here.
It's a brilliant opportunity for us because it brings together our hero, literally, and someone who we look up to. But at the same time, it's also very challenging. So although, yes, meeting Colin Montgomery overwhelms you, but you still have to keep your focus and focus on the game.
The tournament was held very great. And because of Colin Montgomery also came, it became very exciting for us. So I have a chance to meet a very successful player. And to play a very good course like this, it's a great opportunity.
Oh, this tournament should happen every 6 months. Even if Colin comes here every 6 months, it will be a pleasure.
It was a great organized tournament. I say the way they've done it, Hero Cycles, and of course Colin standing there all day, it's not easy. And so it's been a great event. And really thanks to Hero and Colin.
Mr. Montgomery, because of his 2008 Ryder Cup, he had about, I guess, 300 yards to the green. He had a brilliant three-wood, saved Europe with half a point.
He's a very friendly man. I found him very good. He has a very easy swing, you know. He's nice, though. He's a very good guy, and he always supports junior golf. And he helped me today hit my shot at fifth.
He seems a very nice and gentle man, and obviously he's super at golf.
We have a good chance. It depends how my partner plays. Still, we'll try to give a good positive score.
There are chances because I shot a good score, and if my partner shoots around the same score, like 4-5, we have a big chance. Like other schools have played around 9-10 of the team total, and if she plays less than 5 or 5, we win.
We can win. We've got a great team, me and my partner. We've been going on our best form now, so I think we have a great chance of winning.
Any golf tournament that you go to across the world has a finer nuance attached to it, which is a finer nuance very particular to that tournament that you're playing. And right here at the Delhi Golf Club today, the flagship part about this tournament is the players are getting a chance to interact with the European legend Colin Montgomery and play off on the fifth hole with him. As you can see behind me, Colin is teeing off with each of them personally and independently and interacting with them on their game as well. We also caught up with these players and saw their reaction on interacting with the legend himself.
Come on, let's have a photo with the group. Come on.
With me, of course, from the Delhi Golf Club is Colin Montgomery, who has come down to India, flown down especially for the Hero Cup 2014. Colin, welcome to India. And
thank
tell
you.
Us about your association with Hero and how Pankaj decided to bring you down to India.
Well, we've known each other for a while, and when he mentioned this, the Duke of Edinburgh Cup, of course, the winners here will go to Windsor Castle in England, and a very special place it is too. So it was obvious that I could come out here and support him. Great to be here. Great to see the kids play this morning, the children. Fantastic standard of golf. And we have to thank Hero. You know, we have to thank Hero Cycles for bringing this all together.
Now, what do you think of the quality of junior golfers in this country today? Are we on par with the rest of the world, or do we have a long way to go before we get there? And what is really lacking in terms of our country?
Golf is very still a very young sport. I mean, you're very much a cricket nation, and cricket, hockey and football's coming up. But golf is a very young sport still.
Yeah.
But what I've seen this morning is very exciting. Opportunity given to the youngsters to play the game now. There's more opportunity given. We need to build some more golf courses over here to give even more opportunity to them to play. But it's great they can play these old traditional courses like Delhi Golf Club and to come here and play. And I think it's fantastic to see them perform. And what I've seen for the standard today is very much on a par with the likes of China, Indonesia, Vietnam, Thailand, Japan, Korea. Very much so. This is where the future of golf is in Asia. Europe and America have sort of stagnated really within the game of golf, but Asia is where it's beginning to boom, and I think it's been a delight to see the kids play today.
We're seeing a splendid turn of foot from European golfers today. What is your take on the upcoming and the budding European golfers of the world right now?
Well, we have five out of the top six in the world in Europe, which is the first time that's happened for 20 years. So that's great for European golf. And the more that we have in that area of success, that would breed more success. If we have a great, great, great Indian player, wouldn't that help the rest of India to follow suit? So, great that we're doing well right now, but who knows in the future? But right now, Europe's riding a crest of a wave right now.
All right, on a winding note, when do we see you next in India now?
Well, I'll be coming back for hopefully the next Hero Cycles Cup, which is in March.
Right.
But at the same time, I'd love to come over. I'm doing a golf course in Goa. So I come out to Goa quite a bit, which is a lovely resort. I like to stay there anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm coming to India quite a few times and enjoy it. I love it. I love to see the kids and give opportunity to them to play the game. That's what I was given when I was young.
Right.
And it's great that they are given the same opportunity.
All right. Thank you so much, Colin.
Not at all.
Thank you.
Thank you. So this is a very difficult shot, yeah? Because the pin is located on the top of the hill, yeah? Very difficult shot to get up and down. So I'd encourage you to please try and use this here, a little 8-iron, just a run up there, a run up to the hole, hole the putt. So the ball was always going to go a little bit left to right. And you notice with me, if you stand directly behind me there, you notice I go outside and across. Yes?
I cut across the ball, outside to in. So therefore, the ball is spinning left to right. At address position with the driver, 2 out of 10, okay? Now, we don't hit the ball ever. Don't do this at home, it's a two-shot penalty. But that is where, as I'm going to strike the sand. Because what happens is you're using the sharp leading edge of the club and it digs in. So I'm using the bottom of the club, not the sharp edge, number one. So we come into the bunker, we open the club face there, right? Okay, and we open the club face and we follow through. The only way I'm going to do this is, one, is half the battle is we believe it's going to go in. So I aim at this ball here. I aim through the hole. The hole should get in the way. Oh, if I was tight on the putter grip, no good. I want to feel the putter head. 2 out of 10. There. Putt through.
For us to slip into a short break right here on Tea Time. On the other side, we take a look at who the winners really are of this particular tournament and also hear from the legend Colin Montgomery himself on how to really become a champion and what does it really entail to become a champion in sports. All this and more on the other side. Stay with us.
And it's great to see. It really is. I saw a lot of young girls performing as well today, which is super to see, as well as the men.
Thank you for staying with us on Tea Time and welcome back. And well, what a day it has been in the sweltering heat of New Delhi at the Delhi Golf Club. But of course, there's a winner that is going to be emerging out of this tournament. We're waiting with bated breath to see who the winner really is. And of course, 48 golfers playing for charity. Indeed, quite an amazing day right here in New Delhi. Now, what does it really take to be a champion? Colin Montgomery, the legend from Europe, takes us through it.
You have to have the passion and you have to have the desire. And I saw that today with the juniors, with the questions that they were asking. The passion and the desire was there to want to succeed. Everybody wants to further their lifestyles and to improve their ability to have a great life. And I saw that today in the questions that were being answered and the questions that were being asked. And I think that it's fantastic to see that and to witness it firsthand. And you forget that you play golf in Britain and Scotland and Europe and America, but there's an awful lot happening with golf in Asia as well. And it's great to see. It really is. I saw a lot of young girls performing as well today, which is super to see, as well as the men.
Amongst the girls with 35 points is Nishtha Madan from the Sri Ram School. One over par, gross, Nishtha Madan from the Sri Ram School. So the winners with a big margin, 63 points, it's St. John's Chandigarh, Karandeep Kochar and Javier Singh. Both 15 years old, Karandeep Kochar with 34 points, Javier with 29 points. They win by a margin of 6 points, St. John's Chandigarh. St. John's Chandigarh, congratulations boys. So that's Karandeep Kochar, Javier Singh, winners of the first Hero Cycles Inter-School Tournament.
Nishtha right here, she's the winner of the category A, playing one over par today, and she comes from a golfing family, right? Yes. From the father who's a golfer to the sister really who is playing the Asian Championships, and now you're the budding golfer of the family given the fact that you won this one as well. Your thoughts at this point of time, Nishtha?
Well, nothing, just I guess this is where it all starts. I mean, working hard, so
yeah,
I guess a small tournament, but it's good.
Tell me how much you worked hard for it, who's your coach and who would you attribute your success to?
I coach with Nonita Lal. Yeah. All my success goes to her.
Really?
She's my true hero, true inspiration, and she just keeps helping me, keeps me at it.
All right, so congratulations. What next for you in your golfing career now?
Well, I'll just be playing a couple tournaments in December and maybe a few next summer in the US. So let's see how it goes.
All right, all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, happy faces at the end of the Hero Cycles Golf Tournament 2014 right here with me. Javier and Karan coming out as winners of this tournament this time around. They're both from Chandigarh. They both study in the same school. They have the same coach. They also have the same physical fitness trainer. What were the odds? I mean, you played 2 over par. You played 7 over par. How was your game? Let's start off with you.
It was really good. I missed a little bit of short runs, but it was okay. Overall, I had a good game. Made 4 birdies, so it was a good round.
Interesting. And how about you?
I made few bad bogeys, but I made 2 birdies to recover, so it was fine. It was a good round.
Now, what would you attribute today's victory to? To your coach, to your game, to your parents, to the hard work that you have put into your game?
To everybody.
Really?
To my coach, to my fitness trainer, to my parents, everybody who support me. It's to them.
How about you?
Everything the same, except I'd like to give some more importance to my fitness coach, who's really helped me with this, my game. It's really improved a lot. And also to the other, my parents and my golf coach.
All right, thank you so much and congratulations once again. May you go places. Thank you.